Lately, it seems like everybody keeps on asking about their $2,000 stimulus checks. Even some people are wondering, well, what about my unemployment insurance? Or what about my Social Security benefits? When are those going to actually increase? Well, we have answers and I want to provide that in today's video. What we know are multiple lawmakers are talking about kind of splitting up a package, but actually increasing the amount that the American people get. So it could mean we could see larger stimulus checks. I want to explain exactly what's going on and how this could benefit you if this does happen. So let's get right into it. What we know is that Joe Biden, or actually President Biden, he is president now. So if you hear me say Joe Biden, I've just been doing it for so long. He is President Biden at this time. He has a very aggressive plan in order to tackle this pandemic and provide relief to the American people. We know this, but how aggressive is this plan? Well, we have some insights on that as of today. Right now, President Biden is working his way through 17 executive orders. We know as of right now, he's already signed 4, possibly even more as of creating this video, but as of creating it, he's already signed 4. These include, as of right now, stopping the build of the border wall. That was a key priority that he wanted to do an executive order on, and he did that. It's also a federal mask mandate. We also know he signed one to increase support to underserved communities. That's pretty big. And also rejoining the Paris Climate Accord. Those are the 4 that he has done so far as of right now. We know this is just the beginning, but many people are asking, what is to come next? Well, according to Bernie Sanders, who is now the chairman of the Senate Budget Committee, he stated that what is important now is that Congress shows the American people that they can walk and chew gum at the exact same time. What he is simply stating is that Congress now has the ability to impeach former President Trump. They also can confirm cabinet appointments or cabinet members. And the most important thing is they can go and pass a large and robust stimulus package all at the same time. He says, let's show the American people we can do more than just one thing at a time. So we will see what happens there. Now, I want to play a clip from Bernie Sanders that was done earlier today because he was asked, is he willing to compromise with Republicans on the stimulus package? So let's go ahead and watch that clip together and we will see exactly what he has to say.
You feel like you are willing to come their direction and meet somewhere in the middle?
Look, it's not a question of the middle. It's a question of responding to the crises. I don't know what being in the middle means when half of our population is working paycheck to paycheck, when 40 million people are facing eviction, when we have massive levels of income and wealth inequality. So, of course, I want to work with Republicans. And I would hope very much that my Republican colleagues feel the pain of so many working class people in this country who are trying to feed their kids, trying not to get evicted from their homes, trying to be able to go to a doctor and pay the bills. So bottom line is, we got crises. We have got to respond and respond aggressively. We should reach out to our Republican colleagues, hear what they have to say. But we're not going to spend, if I have anything to say about it, months and months and years and not address the incredible pain that working families in the middle class, small businesses are now experiencing.
Okay, so you can see what he just said. He is open to the idea of working with Republicans at this point. My guess is Joe Biden or President Biden has had a little bit of a talk with him, somewhat of a conversation to get him on board with, let's work with the other side of the aisle and let's figure out, can we come to a bipartisan agreement? If we can, that will be much better and it will show unity in Congress. So that's what they're working on. Right now, President Biden, his goal is to unify the American people, unify Congress, and just show unity across the board. When he speaks, he talks about unification, being united. That's what he says almost every single speech. So I firmly believe he does actually mean this. Now, what we know is that even though Bernie Sanders would be willing to work with Republicans, if they're willing to work with him, He also wants something done quickly, unless the size of this bill will increase as time goes on. What he said yesterday was very telling of where Congress currently stands on how soon stimulus could eventually be rolled out. Bernie Sanders said this: "Amid so much economic suffering and despair, it is imperative that Democrats pass a bold and aggressive economic agenda within the first 100 days of Joe Biden's presidency." Now, to give you an idea of how long 100 days is, well, you know how long it is. It's a little bit of time, but this 100 days would go from today until Friday, April 30th. That's 100 days. I believe we can get a lot done in 100 days, but do I believe that we will see a bold and aggressive agenda within the first 100 days of President Biden's time in office? I hope so. I hope so, being that March 14th is when unemployment benefits run out. That's going to be a cliff. That's going to be a cliff that we cannot get to, but we'll talk about that in just a minute. According to multiple reports earlier today, many lawmakers are wanting to split the $1.9 trillion stimulus package into two different parts. That's what they're currently discussing, is can we split this? Because right now, is unemployment benefits, should that be something that is going to hinder talks on vaccinations and talks on additional stimulus and talks on state and local government funding, if we will not even see additional unemployment benefits, that additional $100, because it will go from $300 to $400 as of March 14th. If we're not even going to see that until March 14th, why are we going to negotiate that in January? Why can't we just push that off and we can negotiate that in February or the beginning part of March? Why don't we just push it off? Well, that's currently what's being discussed. The first part of the stimulus package, which was going to make it larger than the $1.9 trillion, the first part would include vaccine distribution funding. Now, as to how much, this would probably be around $300 billion, $200 to $300 billion, if it is negotiated and it's compromised with Republicans. We also know there'd be an additional stimulus check. However, according to a few reports, one senator who doesn't want to be named, probably for good reason, suggests $400 stimulus checks. So an additional stimulus check for $400. And that would come quickly. That would come very quickly, hopefully within the month of February. Now, before you go ahead and bash whoever this is, and I don't know who it is, if anybody knows, let me know, because none of the reports I've read says who the senator is. But if one of you knows or have heard, let me know down in the comment section below. But this person wants to provide $400 stimulus checks in this round to get the overall stimulus from the last, the $600 plus $400 up to $1,000. And then they'd provide an additional $1,000 later on, but that would be extremely targeted to those hardest hit, to those lower median income areas. That's what we're hearing. There would also be minor state and local government funding, not a huge package of $350 billion, probably somewhere closer to $200 billion. Still, it's a good amount of money. Even something closer to $150 billion. That would still help out multiple states and many localities. There's also talks that if we do this, we should also provide liability protections to businesses and also additional worker protections, which is key. And also, let's provide that $150 to $170 billion for school funding as well, because this is going to help kids get back to school, which will help parents actually go back to work, which is key to actually opening up the economy. Some are saying that if this could be agreed upon in the ballpark of roughly $600 to $700 billion, then most Republicans would go for this now. With very little negotiations, they would go for this now. So when I read this, it made it sound like the way it was written was the senator that was speaking, the reports that were being written, were coming from a more Democratic side, which would mean it would be more of a Democratic senator. So a Democratic senator is talking about a $400 stimulus check. Again, I don't know who the senator is, so if you know, please let me know down in the comment section below, because I really want to know. No reports are currently saying. They all say an unspecified senator. Now, however, this does leave, if we go and split up the packages, this does leave multiple policies out of this next stimulus package, which would be around $600 to $700 billion. Again, this is stuff that nobody's really talking about right now because it is so new. This is just an idea that's being thrown out. It's being thrown about like, hey, why don't we do this? My guess is, again, this is just my guess, the senator that's talking about a $400 stimulus check is probably somebody within the Problem Solvers Caucus. That's my guess. Now, many things would be left out of this policy or this package. In addition to that there's a lot of stuff that would not be included and would have to be renegotiated later on, Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi have both said that they do not want to pass standalone packages. However, some experts currently say that this has all changed due to the fact that Democrats now hold all the power. So Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer would most likely go and pass a standalone bill. And in addition to breaking up these policies, this would also allow Congress to potentially pass a third stimulus check. And this is what we're hearing. Right now, we got $600. If we get an additional $400, and this $400 goes to every single person that received that initial $600, and that could be pushed out the door within weeks. If that happens, then on the next one, let's provide an additional $1,000, but only to those that were hardest hit. Maybe we go off of the 2020 tax return. Again, this would push this back into April or May. But if we go off of 2020 tax returns, that could really open the door to a whole new idea. So right now, again, this is just what's being talked about. This is just a report from one senator, again, that wanted to be unnamed. And I get why. If this is a Democratic senator coming out and saying, let's provide $400 now first, they'd probably be bashed because Democrats or President Biden promised $2,000 stimulus checks. And so then they come out and say, no, let's just do $400. And then we'll come back, we'll provide a big one of $1,000. But that won't come to everybody. That will only be to those that were hardest hit, that actually saw a loss in income. So we're going to go off of 2020 income. Well, again, that opens a whole new set of doors. And that is what many Republicans have said is, let's wait. Let's put a pause. Let's put a pause on this and reevaluate. So what we know right now is that breaking up this $1.9 trillion stimulus package would provide larger checks to the American people. This would not be larger in the form of a direct payment through stimulus checks, but it would be larger because it would most likely provide an additional $400 per week in unemployment benefits. Here's the reason why. If Congress were to go and pass a big and robust, large stimulus package now, that includes, let's say, $400 unemployment checks, unemployment, you know, per week bonus. The problem with that, and this would possibly go for an additional 28 weeks, all the way till the end of September, September 30th. If they do this, and let's say the unemployment rate actually goes up, which many people are expecting, it's going to go up. If it goes from 6.7% and it goes up over 7%, what we are seeing is that, or hearing, is that we could see a larger unemployment benefit than those additional $400 per week. That could potentially go up to $450, possibly all the way up to $600 where it once was. And we could also see it scale as the unemployment rate drops over the spring and the summer. We could see it drop down with it. So $600 at 7%, then we get down to, let's say, in the 6%, maybe that goes to $500, and then we get down to 5%, maybe that gets down to $300 per week, and it just keeps dropping. That's what we're hearing. And there were proposals back in, I think, was it June, July, August, that let's provide a package where if the unemployment rate drops, so does the weekly benefit for unemployment. So again, this is where we could see larger checks to the American people. We also know there could be more money for rental assistance and also SNAP benefits. There's more here that could be provided to the American people as well, but this is just what we're hearing. Now, the goal with breaking up this large stimulus package is just to get it passed quickly and provide funding for vaccines. Now, we heard earlier today, and there were reports and kind of rumors that President Biden, he signed an executive order to stop the build of the border wall so that he can redirect funds. So here's currently what is being reported. Again, these are, right now, I'd say these are more rumors than full-on reports. But here's what's being reported. That President Biden and the Biden administration is going to take the funds, the leftover funds from the border wall build, and redistribute that to vaccine distribution. Again, I believe this can be done. I believe this can be done because this is exactly what President Trump did, or former President Trump did, when he took FEMA funds and redistributed that money over to unemployment to provide $300 per week for, I believe, 6 to 7 weeks. So this sounds like it's possible. It sounds like it's an idea. And again, the Biden administration, their priority right now is bold and aggressive action to see change and relief to the American people. So right now, this is actually looking somewhat promising. But according to many lawmakers, they do not expect, and again, this is why we want to break it up, they do not expect a comprehensive, a large and robust stimulus package to pass before February, before the end of February. They are talking about, let's see if we can get this passed sometime in March, possibly in April. Well, it's January 20th. So let's say we go until April 20th. Well, that's what, 90 days? That's ridiculous. That's too long, and the American people will suffer. Here's what we know. There is a drop-dead date for Congress as of right now. I misspoke the other day, and I said it was March 14th, because March 14th is technically when the unemployment rates, or the unemployment or unemployment benefits expire. Here's the issue. It's actually not March 14th, it's March 26th, pushing it back another week, another 12 days, almost 2 weeks. Here's the issue with that, and this is the reason why this is the next drop-dead date. Because Congress, or actually the Senate, they go on recess on March 26th. That is their last day in Capitol Hill. Then they go on recess for 2 weeks. They do not come back to Washington until April 12th. April 12th. That's over 2 weeks. That's way too long. And that's the reason why that, and March 26th, is the actual drop-dead date. So, right now, again, this is looking somewhat promising. We are getting reports that there's new ideas being thrown about. But as always, I'll have to provide you with more information as we get that information. Currently, President Biden is doing exactly what he said he would do. He's signing multiple executive orders, and he's doing this on day one. He wants to get those out of the way. When to get that done, let's move on to the next order of business. The Senate and Vice President Harris has already sworn in the three Democratic senators earlier today, actually just a little while ago. And now it is up to Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer to bring the stimulus package to the floor of both the houses and actually get them passed. Again, as we know more, I promise I'll share more, but this is what we know regarding the stimulus negotiations at this point. But as always, I will provide more information as we know more. Just want to thank you guys for watching. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Consider subscribing so I can continue to keep you updated on everything that's going on. And I'll see you guys on the next one.